Shalom, everybody. Hope you're doing well. Usually I say I hope your week was well, but I want to say now I hope your year was incredible and amazing. We entered the last few hours of this year, making the bridge to this next new year that's coming forward soon. And on some level, like, what can we even say? Like, there's nothing even to say. There's a million things to say. There's nothing to say. And it's just like so beautifully overwhelming, these last moments, this last day. We're told so many amazing things about this last day before we even enter into the new year. We can barely even speak about the new year, as we spoke about last Erev Shabbat, how this last year is not even a reality of a reality yet, because it has not even yet begun. But of course our eyes are looking back in this past year, looking in the present moment, looking forward. So many things happening this last day. We should be blessed to hold it together, to merit to something really beautiful in these last few moments of this incredible year, before the next incredible year B'ezrat Hashem begins. I just want to share two quick thoughts that learning about, thinking about this past day or so. One is comes from a great Rav in Yerushalayim, Rav Tzvi Meir Zilberberg, who stresses so much like these last moments, right? Hakol holech acharei hachitum. Everything goes after, like, the ceiling, after the end, after the last final moments, right? And he says, you know, we learned that Yom Echad Bashana Nechshav Shana, that one day of the year is considered as if a whole year, right? And he says that all the blessings and all the things that we could have done, that we were meant to do, that Hashem wanted to bless us with all the blessings and all the shef and all the great things, and maybe for whatever reason we didn't merit to receive, to do, to get on this one last day of the year, this one last 24-hour period, we can merit to do incredible things, all those things that we missed, right? To achieve all the things we didn't achieve this whole year. It sounds like crazy, right? It sounds like, how is that even possible? Right? One day is so powerful. One moment is so powerful. We have no idea. Right? We open ourselves up to this reality. We can do and achieve incredible things, both in thought, in speech, and in action. And he continues to say that it might seem like this last of the year, like all these things are happening, like all these tests and all these challenges to, like, keep it holy, to keep it real, to keep it together, you know? And he says that that's part of it as well. Hashem throws at us all these tests on this final day to remain patient, to remain sometimes even sullen, not to respond, to just like give a sweet face to others and to say sweet words and have positive thoughts. And the smallest things that we do in this day can help us to merit incredible, incredible things in this last day of the year. So I bless us that we, you and me together, should really merit that together. The last thought I wanted to share, something I was learning last night from the Kedushas Levi, Rabbi Levi Yitzchak of Berditchev. He said something so awesome, and I'm feeling it, and maybe you're feeling it as well. You know, this last of the year, like, it's so overwhelming. Like, how can we possibly even achieve anything? It's so overwhelming, right? How can we even approach Rosh Hashanah? How can we even approach, you know, like the Mishnah says, like, we're standing in front of Hashem tomorrow and the next day as well. How can we possibly even approach it? It's like, it melts us. It's too much. It's so overwhelming. It's so powerful. And the Levi Yitzchak of Berditchev, he says, he's like, exactly. This day is so incredible. It's so awesome. We call it like the days of awe for a reason. Like, it's so overwhelmingly incredible and beautiful and awesome. Like, how can I possibly stand in front of the Creator of the world, in front of the Creator of everything? I'll melt. I can't even open up my mouth. And he says, exactly, how can we even possibly open up our mouth? So on one level, like, we're inspired, we're encouraged, we're motivated to, like, say every single tefillah and every bakasha, every request, every prayer that we ever thought of, that we ever can feel in this moment, everything. This is the day. This is, Rosh Hashanah is a day that is a sugula. It's a spiritual fitting. I can't even translate the word right now. It's just an auspicious day for prayer and for asking for everything related to ruchnias, to spirituality, to gashmias, to physicality. But on some level, how can I even open up my mouth when I'm standing in front of the Creator of everything? Like, I'm just melting. I'm not even existing anymore. I'm like, I'm just totally nullified in this experience, in this moment. And Kedushas Levi says, exactly. So you know why? You know what we do? We just stand still and we listen to the shofar being blown. Why do we have the shofar on Rosh Hashanah? Because this day is so overwhelmingly awesome. It's so incredible that I can't even open up my mouth. I can barely pray. I can barely speak. Right? So that's why we have the shofar. When we're standing in just such awe, we're just like, we just like stutter, we mumble, we mutter, right? And that's the sound of the shofar. The shofar is that muttering. It's that babbling. It's that trying to put some kind of sentence together. Right? I mean, we can't put a sentence together, so we just listen to the shofar. And the shofar speaks for us, and Hashem understands everything. Hashem understands everything we want to say, everything we want to daven about and for, and everything we want to ask for and request. The shofar speaks it all. So if you're feeling a little stuck this Rosh Hashanah, don't worry. A lot of people, I think, are. Right? We should be blessed, we should be zochet, we should merit to just stand and hear the sound of the shofar and hear all of our prayers and all of the prayers of Am Yisrael and all the prayers. Of the entire world. And all of the prayers since the beginning of creation and of existence and all the prayers until the end of times, they're all being voiced, they're all being shared in the sound of the shofar. Ah, B'zat Hashem, we should hear it. B'zat Hashem, we should feel it. And even if we don't, we should just know it. That's what's happening. Ah, I bless us to be melted away in this. I bless us to be melted away by this awesome day that's upon us so soon. To take advantage of these last few moments of this incredible year and use them to build a beautiful new year that should bring blessing to all of us, all of Am Yisrael, to the entire world. To bring the final light of redemption to this world that we know we so, so deeply need. Love and blessings from the land of Israel. Shana tova, shana tova, shana tova.